A very good evening to one and all present here. Amazing to see the people and especially the students do good in our lives. As a coach, as a mentor, what you think is important? Imparting the education or imparting it so well that one day your students make you feel proud about their achievements? Winning is one thing, participating is another. But you are at the highest moment of ecstasy when your students do good. As a mentor, you feel proud and you feel that you've been able to achieve what you've been trying to do all these years. Small competitions with a great competitive spirit helps not only you as a mentor, but the students who want to yearn and do something good in their lives. Winning is not only about celebrations. It's about the confidence, it's about the motivation, and it is about the inspiration. We at the Talk Room keep on organizing such activities for the students across India and globally. This year, our second annual online debate championship was held last week, and across the country, almost 15 to 20 schools participated with us. We had some great speakers with us, and I was in awe of these speakers when I, at this age, thought, what would I actually do? How to start with? These children knew it all. Yes, today I present you all the winners of Online Debate Championship. In fact, the second Online Debate Championship. Please welcome Ghazifa and Basira, the winning team. Girls, can we have you on the screen, please?
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
thank ma'am. You so much. Our second runner-up, you're welcome. Our second runner-up, Bhavya Malhotra. Hi, Bhavya.
Thank you, ma'am. Thanks so much.
Welcome. She shared her prize with Riddhi. Hi, Riddhi.
Good evening, ma'am. Thank you for having me.
My pleasure. We have Ashwin Kaur, the first runner-up. Hi,
good
Ashwin.
Evening, thank you for having me here today.
Our pleasure. And definitely the champion of the debate competition, we have Aishi Arora. Welcome, Aishi.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for having me.
Thank you so much for coming. It is really an honor to actually see you all on the screen because you are the next gen who's going to be the leading speaker. Well, let me start with the debating team that was actually the team that was the winner. All right, Ghazifa and Basira, I want to know from both of you, how was your experience of debating in this competition?
Ma'am, the experience was really, really amazing. Actually, it was our English teacher who told us that this debate is going to be organized and stuff. She sent us the link when we were preparing for our midterm examinations. And during our preparatory holidays of the exams, we just wrote the entire speech. And during the exam days, we used to kind of learn the speech in chunks. And it was on 11 June that our exams got like completed. And on 12th, we had our speech. So at that night of the 11th June, we were learning the entire thing. And on the cherry on the top was that we were the first speakers to be called out to speak in the debate. So yeah, the experience was really amazing. It taught us a lot of things.
Yes, it did taught us a lot of things. Like we learned that we could multitask a lot. Like we actually doubted ourselves that we couldn't, but then we actually, you know, explored ourselves and we're like, yes, we can multitask. And we also got to know, you know, we got experience in this debating and we actually mastered it, I think.
Of course you did. And that's why I think you're the winning team. Amazing. It was actually a flawless performance, I must say. And definitely, there are so many things that are hidden inside of us and we really don't know our capabilities until we are put into the hot waters. So yes, definitely, ma'am. It was a great experience for us as well to hear you. And we are honored and we really feel, you know, happy that you actually were a part of the competition. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Bhavya, coming to you. How did you prepare for this competition?
The topic artificial intelligence is something which I'm also very passionate about and knowing more. My mom, who is a software engineer, helped me know more about this topic. We did so many discussions about this, and I was able to learn a lot more about this. So it was an amazing experience for me and very enriching too.
Awesome. It was enriching for us to hear from you, definitely. Riddhi, how was your experience as a debater and where you think you could improve a little more?
Okay, so it was my first time debating. From very beginning, I have been always a girl, very shy, introvert. But this time I gave a chance to myself. I always see my friends, they participate in these extracurricular activities. You know, they encourage a lot. And this time I just decided that I have to do these. So it was my first experiences doing debate. Yeah, I think I need a little more work to, you know, give time or to focus on. I feel shy. I still feel shy. And that's the thing I need to work on.
I think you were pretty good. And that's what we were talking about. We never know about our hidden potentials. And once when we start to work on it and, you know, a little boost, maybe, you know, this coming up as a second runner is just that little motive, a little boost to you that, oh, yes, I can do it. So it's just like, you know, you are unleashing your talents and your potentials.
Yes, lovely. Ma'am. It was really a great opportunity.
Wonderful. Ashman, you have been a speaker at the national level too. How did you feel here to be like a contestant and debating? Because most of the times you've been into what I know is extempores and speeches. So as debater, how was your experience?
It was a new experience all over because I think this is the second time that I've been participating in my debate. And I was quite nervous. Yes, it turned out to be quite good. And although everyone was quite competitive and there were awesome speakers, but still I managed to get the second prize. So I was quite elated.
All right. Aishi, you were the one. I think you got it because no other participant was as active, as predominant in asking the questions. You were an active listener. That's what came from the judges to me. And they noticed you had a spark of debating. How was your experience and how often do you keep on, you know, participating in debates?
Ma'am, the experience was really good. I've been debating for the past 6 years. So basically, it's the last debate I did because my school is just about to get over. So I think it was a very good experience and all the hard work I've been giving to debating since so many years just paid me off, I think.
Amazingly, I think it did because you were the spark, as the judges said. I'm quoting the judges here. They said that you were the spark of this session and undoubtedly we all witnessed that. My question to you, Gazeta and Basira, is what do you think are the important qualities that debaters must have, according to you?
Ma'am, according to me, the debater should have that kind of an personality that could draw, you know, that could just move a crowd. They should have that kind of a confidence that they make the other people kind of agree to the statements they are making. So confidence and a strong personality, I guess, is really important.
Okay.
For me, I think it's confidence that actually moves you, moves the crowd. And it's the body language that, you know, you make audience see yourself there. And that's, you know, body language speaks it all. And as Gazfa said, confidence should be there. It's very important.
Absolutely. I completely agree with it. And I definitely speak in many of my lectures and speeches. Confidence is one key. If you have it, it can open any lock.
Yes,
if you have that confidence, you know, it definitely helps you to move ahead because you have a say which you can write, expose it in front of everyone. And I think when it comes out of confidence, the other person, if he also has some doubts, will never try to disagree with you.
So yeah, exactly.
One thing that as a debater is absolutely important. Bhavya, do you think of anything else except for this?
Confidence is an important part, and I think that knowing what you are saying, knowing the topic and gathering information about it is also a very important aspect. So that would be important.
Very, very true. Riti, as you said that you are a shy person, did you find any change? I mean, it's like you participated in the debate for the first time. What was the change that you saw in yourself? Now as a debater, do you see somewhere else a debater to yourself?
Yeah. Okay, so ma'am, before the debate, I practiced in front of the mirror. I was very nervous. I was like, I'm not gonna do anything. But later on, it turned out to be a very good experience, a very amazing experience. I just told myself that it's okay that to get nervous and all. Later by later, you come across them. You come over your worries. And yeah, that's all.
All right. Ashman, there is one thing that all the debaters fear to face is the rebuttal round. Though we kept it quite short, like one question, looking at the time constraints and also. How do you think a child must handle the rebuttal thing?
Even I think that rebuttal is the most difficult part of a debate. But when I was practicing my debate, I was told that whenever you are participating in the rebuttal, you must stick to your point. Just keep your point and whatever is the answer. You have to turn your answer around that point. You just need to stick to that point and your answer will automatically get framed.
So, yeah. Lovely. That's a lovely information you've given us. That's right. Aishi, as you were the one who was putting up a number of questions, what do you think leads to asking a question in a debate? See, it is definitely one who's asking the question definitely shows out. What do you think is that one quality for the rebuttal that is quite important as a participant?
Ma'am, I believe answering that question with the same confidence with which we spoke a debate is one thing. And then as being against the topic, I had to ask. So I believe it was like my point of view was something else and the speaker's point of view was something else. And it was just like I had to contradict it because I was obviously believing against it. So that is the thing I believe everybody should keep in mind while asking a question.
Lovely. And I think somewhere it requires active listening. It is quite important that you are an active listener when in debate because you have to contradict the other's point and you've actually got to be quite an active listener. Simultaneously being a speaker, it is quite important. Ghazifa and Basira, my question that is definitely for you only, what is the teamwork as you won as the team in debate? How does a team actually prepare for the debates? How do they comprehend with each other? I want to know about that because we could see a lovely chemistry between you two.
Ma'am, the most important thing in teamwork is understanding your partner. It's like managing both of your affairs like unanimously, okay? It's like I needed to understand that where Basira is lacking, I need to just kind of move myself at that point. So it's really, really important that you understand in your partner in the teamwork because you both are going to represent as a single entity. So you need to be really confident in yourself and make sure that your partner is comfortable when you are speaking. Your partner is comfortable with you and you really need to understand your partner well. So yeah.
Yes. And you need to put equal amount of hard work as your partner is putting in. As she said, you need to understand each other. And then most important is you need to put your hard work because you can't do anything if you don't put in your hard work. You have to see where your partner's flaws are so that she can, make herself better on that. And she can tell me where I was going wrong and I can make myself better on that. And I think that's something most important. And we were sisters, so we can understand each other more better way.
Helping each other out is something that helped us.
True. And I think being sisters, that worked very well because the chemistry was very evident. It was quite evident in your speeches. I mean, the moment one was done, the other, the judges really had a tough time. Oh, God. And they said, it's a teamwork. And they undoubtedly had to give it to you. That's a wonderful idea. Riddhi, how do you think, what is the reaction of your parents? I'm coming to you for this question because a child is shy, not speaking, and, she bagged the prize. And that too, second runner-up. So how was the reaction at home?
Okay, so I just told them the day I got the prize. So they were like, are you kidding or something? Because I had told you, and I have always been a person introvert, shy, kind of not participating in these extracurricular activities. But they were really very happy. They just, my dadi, she went to the temple, and then she gave me prasad that ki meri beti ne kuch kiya hai. So she was really very happy for me that, and even my parents were very happy.
Oh, that's lovely. And I think you brought laurels to the school as well. So the school is also happy. Lovely. That's awesome. Bhavya, how do you think, you know, these debates and these competitions, how are they important for in a student's life? And what role do they play? Such activities, what role do they play in your life?
Ma'am, I think for me, it did create exposure, and I was able to learn more about these things, because I remember my first debate was in fourth standard and I was not interested at all in these things. I came up to my mom and told her about it. And she, I think, had some experience in her school, so she told me that you should give it a go. And I did it. And when I did, I got really into it. I think the reason is that it also enhances the self-confidence a lot. It did for me, and self-confidence, exposure, all these things matter a lot. And that's why I think debating plays an important role.
Ashwin, what is the most difficult part to debate?
I think it is rebuttal. Because, yes, you don't know what question is coming to you and how you have to tackle it. Of course, you should stick to the point. But still, you know, there is something that, yes, a question aane wala hai. So there is some self-confidence, I think. There is, you get stuck there. So, yeah, I think it's the rebuttal.
All right. How many of you do actually agree with this? That an extemporaneous rebuttal is something that gives you nerves and butterflies in stomach, then this is going to come up. I think most of us do feel the same about rebuttal until and unless we've experienced it at a greater level. But I think usually with your practice, with your preparation, with your experience, this also goes away. So nothing to worry about it. Aishi, you might have prepared something extraordinary that you got it. What was that extra in that ordinary?
Ma'am, I think before writing a debate, what we have been practicing for so long is that we consider for and against both. And after we have written both the sides, then we decide which one we are convinced with most. So I think maybe that is the thing that I could basically realize what has to be said in a for and what has to be said in an against. And that is why I could rebuttal myself and I could rebuttal others as well.
Okay, that's really a great point. And there are some lovely comments that are coming to you girls. If anybody looks at this, they might think that we had been a little partial because it's all a girls' game. But well, it wasn't actually any intention. The boys also did pretty well. But it was luckily that when we came out with the results, even we were surprised that it's a girls' game this time. So, any last note, Ghazifa and Basira, that you want to leave with?
We'd just like to give this message to all the youngsters out there. Just don't shy off from speaking your heart out. Your ideas, your perspectives, your way of thinking, your side of story does matter. Your ideas have got the potential to just move the mountains. So just don't shy off from speaking yourself and be confident in whatever you do, because you have got the potential to.
Taking on what Ghazifa said, you need to be confident in what you are, because your wills matter and you matter. You're unique and your uniqueness is there. That has some value. So just give it a try. And when you give your best, there is no stopping.
Absolutely. And there's no stopping for you girls. I'm so proud of you.
Thank you.
Bhavya, any last note for your viewers?
I would like to add to what Ghazifa and Basira said, that speak yourself, express yourself, don't shy away, and just be confident.
Thank you. Riddhi, I pass on the baton to you.
So I want to say all the best to all the viewers, and yeah, just be confident. Don't let your worries rule you.
Cool. Okay, Ashwin.
I would like to add to what everybody said, that just be you. Don't try to copy anyone. Just be yourself and be the best version of yourself.
Lovely. Aishi?
I think everybody should start believing in themselves more, because actually debating or putting your thoughts forward is a kind of true empowerment, and everybody deserves it. So I think everybody should actually have the will to speak what they feel and be confident in them.
Awesome. I think after these lovely messages, I should zip myself up, because there's nothing more to say. You've all said it all. And coming from you people, definitely it's going to make a difference, remarkably a difference, in people of your fraternity. The speakers at your age who are looking up to being what they want to be. There are some hesitations, there are some restrictions that we have created in our own minds. Don't let those hesitations and restrictions be your hurdles. Just come out, just be you. Just be the best version, as they all said. I think I'm just repeating what they all said. And it was remarkably, it made a difference having you all. It was a learning for us indeed. And we feel so proud that the next gen is coming up with such lovely speakers out there. So all my good wishes from my team and myself. May you rule the world in the coming up times. And definitely, I think you are going to do that. Thank you so much. It was a pleasure having you all. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much,
ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Pleasure. Thank you, viewers, for being here and passing on such lovely best wishes and comments for our people here. Thank you so very much.